the Welsh. They love their winners. I'm the undefeated super middleweight champion of the world. Yet I'm still looking for the respect, the recognition, and the admiration I deserve. I know to be the best, I have to fight the best. I'm Joe Calzaghe. I'm ready, willing, and able. And I'm next on Showtime Championship Boxing.
Welcome you to Europe's youngest capital. We're in the maritime city of Cardiff, Wales, a picturesque metropolis filled with historic landmarks and medieval architecture. Tonight, the natural beauty and distinctive charm of this country will play host to a favorite son who's no ordinary Joe in these parts. In our main event, it's another defense on home turf for local sensation Joe Calzaghe, who puts his WBO super middleweight crown and undefeated record on the line against former world champion and number six contender Charles the Hatchet Brewer. This one has all the elements of a slugfest. And in our co-feature, a true homecoming for unbeaten Gary the Rocket Lockett, rated number five in the world by the WBO. His Intercontinental Junior Middleweight belt is at stake versus Russian champion Yuri Tsarenko. As we bring you inside to the Cardiff International Arena, where a capacity crowd of about 5,000 is expected. Currently, Great Britain has but three world champions, so each is a precious commodity, and one of those titleists will be center stage this evening. On top of that, he's a Welshman. But while Joe Calzaghe enjoys celebrity status locally, the world stage is another story. An impressive win tonight could change all that. It's fight night in Cardiff. Hello again, everybody. Steve Albert ringside from Cardiff, Wales. Well, Sugar Ray Leonard once reigned at super middleweight, and so did Roy Jones. But in recent years, the 168-pound division has been dominated by foreign-born champs, none of whom have had worldwide respect or appeal. Now there's Joe Calzaghe. He's undoubtedly the best in Wales, arguably the best at 168. He may also be on the verge of superstardom, yet he's still in search of respect. Why? Well, for starters, he's never fought in the States, and he's never had that defining breakout fight. To break through, Calzaghe needs a major upgrade in quality of opposition. The dangerous Charles Brewer is a step up tonight, but Calzaghe's ultimate goal is a showdown with undisputed middleweight champ Bernard Hopkins, or the aforementioned Jones, now the world light heavyweight king. With that, let me bring on my ringside partner, former world champ Bobby Chez. And Bobby, is Brewer Calzaghe's biggest test?
Well, Steve, Calzaghe has beat the likes of Chris Eubank, Robin Reed, two former world champions, and Omar Sheikha, a top 10 challenger. So on paper, with eight losses, Brewer may not stack up to look as tough as those men, but with his style, he may be just the opposite. He can box, he's got good reach, he can punch. The big question is his chin. He's been knocked out by fighters who don't appear to hit as hard as Joe Calzaghe. That's the big question. He's got a great trainer in Bobby Boogaloo Watts. If his chin holds up and he's in the zone, this could be a war, and yes, Calzaghe's toughest test to date.
Will victory tonight help launch Calzaghe's career in the U.S.?
I think it'll help give him some respect in the U.S., but not launch it. He needs to beat a household name. Once again, as long as Brewer has eight losses, they're expecting an undefeated champion to beat a man with eight losses. It's almost a given, even though it's not. He needs to beat a name to become a name. It's that simple.
Well, both have predicted knockouts, so we should have fireworks tonight. Joe Calzaghe isn't a household name in the States, but here in Wales, he's a national hero. The Southpaw does have punching power, and it's clear that if he knocks off some name fighters, Calzaghe just might reach his star potential on both sides of the Atlantic.
I've worked all my life. Been boxing for 20 years, 21 years. It's a long time. I've only been recognized, obviously, as world champion 4.5 years. But all that work I've done, you know, all that sacrifice as a child, I'm reaping the rewards now. Now when I walk down the street, obviously I'm recognized. Everybody in Wales is proud of my achievements. everyone comes up the street and say, you're doing Wales proud, you know, and that makes me feel good. And to put a smile on a, you know, somebody's face, you know, it was really good that I'm in that position that I can do that.
Oh my God.
You know, a lot of people have said, you know, you should go to training camp and whatnot. But I do all my work at home, you know, it's great countryside, we have great hills to run. You know, I bring the sparring partners in, and it's where I'm happy, you know, it's where I'm content. You know, I get a bit edgy if we do the fight. I think everybody stays a little bit away from me. You know, even my dad, who's a trainer, you know, sort of, if I've got sort of somebody to have a go at, we'll have a go at him, have a go at each other. But, you know, I love my dad, he's a great guy, and, you know, he's been with me from the start. And, you know, I owe everything to him, really, what I've achieved.
Joe Calzaghe!
I think I was 2 or 3 years too late. In Britain, you had the great fighters like Nigel Benn, Steve Collins, Chris Eubank, all making millions fighting each other. And when I come along, obviously I beat Chris Eubank, but that's at the end of his career. And at the end of the day, there was no big names left in Britain, or basically anyway. So although I'm dominated the division for 4.5 years, I've lacked this sort of a defining super fight, you know, which I need, really. I think I need a really, you know, a top 10 pound for pound fighter to really show, you know, what I can do. You know, so you just gotta keep plugging away. It's hard work, but I'll get there eventually.
Joe Calzaghe, an attractive fighter on a lot of levels. At the age of 30, he's ready to launch himself. The question is he made of the right stuff? Charles Brewer doesn't think so, calling him Joe Coward-Zaghe, a reference to his so-called lack of quality opposition. Nevertheless, Calzaghe says Brewer will succumb to his power, boxing skills, and the intimidating atmosphere. We'll see if the war of words spills into the ring tonight in our main event. Let's get to our first bout. The Rocket Man, undefeated Gary Lockett, makes his ring debut in his native Wales against Yuri Cirenko for the WBO Intercontinental 154-pound title, light middleweight, as it's called here in the United Kingdom. The challenger and Russian champ, Yuri Cirenko, who's not actually Russian, being from neighboring Belarus, but he spent most of his career across the border in Russia. Biggest win, outpointing vastly experienced Andrei Pestraev, the former European champ and title challenger. Keeps very busy. He fought just 10 days ago, a fifth round stoppage. Bobby only 22 years of age, but he's more experienced than Lockett, but probably overmatched skill-wise.
You know, experience is excellent, Steve, but you know what? Without the skills to go in, it could be meaningless. Lockett appears to be the better boxer, the better puncher, and endurance-wise seems to have better conditioning, so this could be a really long night for Cirenko.
Boxing in the former Soviet Union is a hard school, no concept of building fighters up. They throw them right in with tough opponents. So Cirenko's 12-6-1 record may be a little misleading. Here's Gary Lockett. The locals are raving about this Welsh prospect. Comes off his biggest win, a fourth-round KO over slick Australian veteran Kevin Bones Kelly. You see the crowd reaction. They love the Rocket here. Boy, he just unleashed a barrage on Kelly that began with the right and ended with his most damaging punch, the left hook. That's the Lockett Rocket. The up-and-coming Lockett is 16-0, 13 knockouts. His last win earned him the belt he's defending tonight. What do you think? Are the kudos for Lockett justified, Bobby?
You know, most of the kudos are reasonably well-deserved, Steve, but it's so early in his career. He's never been past 6 rounds, but he has great power in excellent condition. But again, never past 6 rounds. He needs to step up his quality of opposition, and within about a year, he'll be knocking on somebody's door looking for a world title.
It's only his second scheduled 12-round fight, but he averages just 2.5 rounds per fight. Here in the UK, they'd love to see him fight local contenders Wayne Alexander or Takalu, but he's talking like Daniel Santos and Winky Wright. Let's check the numbers as we go to the tail of the tape. At 25, Lockett is 3 years older than Cirenko. 3.5-inch height advantage for the 5'10 Lockett. The reach nearly even, both right at the 154 limit at yesterday's weigh-in. And the key rules for this fringe title affair: there's no standing eight count, no 3 knockdown rule. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. If an accidental headbutt occurs before the end of the fourth round, the fighters ruled a technical draw. If it happens after the end of round four, they'll go to the scorecards. So here at the Cardiff International Arena, we're getting ready for Gary Lockett versus Yuri Cherenko, junior middleweights. We are set for the formal introductions from our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon, Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you, and we welcome you to the International Arena here in Cardiff, Wales, as we have a big night of action coming away, and it's all brought to you by Frank Warren Sports Network in association with Showtime and Red Square. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the World Boxing Organization. The supervisor at ringside is Charles Giles. Along with the British Boxing Board of Control, the steward in charge is Brian Remy. Introducing to you our physicians at ringside, Dr. Ray Monsell, Dr. Jim Naismith, and Mr. Peter Fitzgerald, and our timekeeper at the bell, Neil Berter. Introducing our three judges scoring this bout from ringside, we have from Rouen, France, Robin Dolpierre. From Pontypool, Wales, Roddy Evans. And from London, England, Roy Francis. And our third man of the ring is from Wolverhampton, England, introducing John Coyle. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBO Intercontinental Junior Middleweight Championship. Introducing to you first the challenger on my left. He is fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks with white and red trim, hailing from Minsk, Belarus. He weighed in at 11 stone even, or 154 US pounds. His record stands at 12 wins, 6 losses, 1 draw, with 9 wins coming by way of knockout. He is the Russian light middleweight champion tonight, challenging for the Intercontinental title. Introducing Yuri Cherenko. And his opponent across the ring, ladies and gentlemen, is the defending champion on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing silver trunks with blue trim, hailing and representing Cwmbran, Wales. He weighed in the same as his opponent, 11 stone even, or 154 US pounds, undefeated in his campaign in the ring, with 16 wins, no losses, 13 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the undefeated WBO Intercontinental Junior Middleweight Champion, Gary the Rocket Lockett. Once again, a referee in charge, John Coyle, now to give instructions, 12 rounds of boxing schedule.
Gary, come on. Okay, I've spoken to you both in the dressing room. Obey the rules, obey my instructions, and let's see good sportsmanship, okay? Good luck.
Gary Lockett making his hometown debut, one of the top young European fighters in the talent-rich junior middleweight ranks. He is a power puncher, good left hook. 13 of his 16 wins by knockout, 3 in the first, 11 within 2. Cherenko, the reigning Russian junior middleweight champ, little tough guy, sort of a straight in and back type fighter, more of a slugger brawler. You won't see much lateral movement, throws a decent punch, and he's a little tricky. He said he'll look to feel out Lockett in the first round. Lockett, from what we've seen, Bobby, has pretty good style, educated jab.
He's got a pretty good jab, pretty stiff jab too. He can literally bang with both hands. Sometimes he's a little too straight up and down, and doesn't move side to side, but he is working on, he says.
He's very patient, not reckless, doesn't make too many mistakes, intelligent. Will try to draw opponents onto his countering shots, which is particularly the left hook. Economical with his punches. Missed with that wild left. There's a quiet confidence about Lockett, wearing the light silver trunks with the blue trim. Very respectful, won't badmouth anyone.
He's definitely not a trash talker, but he comes to fight.
He looks like he has world-class power from the tapes that I've seen, but still learning and gaining experience.
There was a nice lead right hand followed by a left hook that was blocked, but the right hand landed very clean. Cherenko took it without much of a problem.
Cherenko may not have the best defense. He's vulnerable to speedy boxer types that move around a lot, but he's very durable.
He also has a great left hook to the body. Saw him slant there and a nice overhand right.
He likes to target the liver, as he put it. And he's tough to get rid of. He's never been stopped all six losses going the distance. But I'll tell you, Bobby, he's up against it tonight against the promising Welshman here in his own backyard.
He sure is. Lockett has good skills, good tools. And there is a rumor that Cherenko tires a bit in the mid-rounds. I saw some tapes on him. Didn't look as active in the mid-rounds. And one of the long, strong suits for Lockett is that he doesn't get tired.
Yes, we approach the final minute of round one. Cherenko does seem to get winded in the middle rounds as Cherenko goes after the body of Lockett. But I've seen Cherenko have that happen to him. Then he recovers and gets a second wind and wins the fight. He knows the tricks. There's that left hook, but it was blocked. The crowd will make noise every time the Rocket Man comes close. Like there. Lockett dictating the tempo. Stepping in. Throwing first. And a straight right hand sends Cherenko back a bit.
So early in the round, Cherenko is pushing Lockett backward. More effective for Cherenko. Now that he's being backed up, Lockett's being much more effective.
Beautiful combination to the head by Lockett. A straight right followed by a left hook. And he scored with those.
Right, step back, both. Back.
As we head for the bell, round one. One of the books. And we are set for our keys to victory, courtesy of Bobby Chips.
We'll start with Gary Lockett. Combinations off the jab. The jab will not only get his range down for him, but it'll bother Cherenko on the way in. Also sharp counterpunching. The shorter Cherenko's gonna try and push him back, needs to block and bang him back. And also land his power shots. This will take its toll on the shorter Russian fighter. For Yuri Cherenko, he needs to push Lockett back the way he did there in the first part of the round. Lockett doesn't fight as well going backward. Also, outwork Lockett. Every once in a while, Lockett is a little too conservative with his punch output. And lastly, left hook to the body. Again, he used that in the first round very well. This will slow down Lockett.
Russell, you're boxing smart, you know what I mean? You only hit you once. Today, Miguel, stand up, suck in, enjoy it, get off the jab and combos.
Colin Moorcroft in the corner of Gary Lockett, who told us he really needs to guard against over-anxiousness, fighting for the first time in front of his hometown fans. Lockett, who lives just about 10 minutes from Joe Calzaghe, and Calzaghe will probably have to deal with the same situation when he fights Brewer later. But Lockett needs to be patient. Remember to jab and counterpunch.
You know, in the first, there's a nice left hook by Lockett leaping in with it. In the first round, Lockett missed a lot more punches than I think he had intended to. And Cherenko outworked him just a little bit. Lockett made the round close, but I thought Cherenko just eked it out.
The anxious part may be over for Gary Lockett, and he looks like he wants to get down to business here in round two.
He's come out very purposeful behind that jab and the left hook, using the right hand as well. Everything's much more on target.
As Cherenko digs to the body with his left hook. Little blood around the nose of Lockett, right nostril. This fight, very last minute for Cherenko. As mentioned, he fought just 10 days ago, but that's nothing new to him. He had 10 fights in 2001, went 6-4, and a couple of occasions he fought fights very close, won 8 days apart. Lockett just walked into a jab. Boy, this guy stays busy.
When you fight 4 and 6 round fights, you know, it's much easier to do that. When you get to 10, 12 round tough fights, the attrition it takes on your body, the toll it takes, you can't do that.
Well, this is scheduled for 12. It's for something called the WBO Intercontinental Junior Middleweight title.
A little more blood flowing from the nose and even a little bit of spit out of the mouth of Gary Lockett.
But Lockett keeps pressing forward. A little bobbing and waving.
And I'll tell you what, there's a little tiny hesitation that Cherenko does, and every single time Lockett fights, he gets hit with that lead right hand.
As Lockett turns it up. A little more movement that we've seen from Cherenko in tapes. trying to stay away from the much talked about left hook of Lockett. Lockett again spitting out blood. His face is getting blood here by the moment.
Cerenko uses head and shoulder feints to draw fire like that.
Good right hand by Cerenko.
He draws the fire up, Lockett, and hits him with that lead right hand. And it's worked
right.
Maybe
step
half a dozen times down the first two rounds.
I mean, that was right on Lockett's chin, but Lockett showing a pretty good beard.
Yeah, that was a clean punch. Very clean.
Stop
a better round for Cerenko.
Little 1 out of 10.
Alright.
Just hanging your head out a little bit long, Gal. Do you hear me? Let's go a little bit snappier at the shots.
Yeah.
Do you hear me?
Yeah.
You're doing well. It's a 12-round fight. It's not a sprint. Do you hear me, Gal?
Watch the nose get bloodied. Cerenko's been hitting him with nice right hands. He stuffs the jab there. They're landing on that nose. And he's been shoulder feinting him and hitting him with the right hand. You'll watch it right now. He slips the shot in. He stuffs the jab in, little hesitation. There's the right hand right on the jaw, slash nose area. Blood, see it spattered all over the face of Gary Lockett.
Double jab cross, get close, don't blow your nose.
Yeah.
You hear me?
Yeah.
Come on, Gal. Gal, off the jab and you come off it, Gary.
Yep.
Don't rush the jab.
This is where the cut man earns his money. Denny Mancini in the corner of Gary Lockett. Lockett in phenomenal condition. He runs the beaches, runs 10 to 12 miles on weekends. So we'll see if that has to factor in if this fight goes deeper. Round 3 of 12. Cerenko coming off a good round in round 2, landed a couple of good right hands on the head of Lockett.
Yeah, early in the round, Lockett came out, established himself, but Cerenko caught him with those right hand counters time and time again.
Cerenko looking very confident. He's in the black and white trunks from Minsk, Belarus. Right uppercut just missed by Lockett.
Left hook attempt there by Cerenko to the body. Lockett avoiding the body completely right now, not really working the body. And there's a good left hook to the body as I say that.
Right on cue. Cerenko missing with a right cross.
Stop boxing! Stop boxing!
John Coyle, the third man of the ring. There's the left hook digging to the body by Lockett. Two in a row. And Cerenko holding on. Lockett starting to score more now regularly. Trying to slow Cerenko down. And he backs Cerenko into the ropes and lets fly.
Not a lot landing there really effectively. A lot of it just hitting off gloves. Better show than go.
No blood from Lockett's nose as in round 2. Less than a minute remaining in the third. A lot more holding and clinching, mostly by Cerenko. Cerenko knows all the tricks. He'll do anything he can, like use shoulders, elbow, he'll throw anything. Right hand over the top, grazing blow by Lockett, and those punches didn't connect as well.
Well, you know what? Lockett's loading up a little more now, and that's telegraphing some of the shots, but his punches are getting harder.
That left landed right on the neck by Lockett. And he's trying to push Cerenko off. Cerenko just hanging on. There's the shoulder by Cerenko.
Tell you what, Lockett's using a little bit of forearm on the inside himself, trying to push Cerenko off and hit him.
Yeah, it's getting a little dirty right now. Off the roughhouse tactics by Cerenko as we head for the bell.
Stop boxing! Okay.
Later tonight, our main event, Joe Calzaghe versus Charles Brewer. At the weigh-in yesterday afternoon, a little controversy. Calzaghe made the weigh.
Joe Calzaghe, 11 stone, 13 and three-quarter pounds.
Just under the 168-pound super middleweight limit, but for Charles Brewer, a different story. At first, he was a pound and three-quarters over. Some anxious moments. Then about an hour later, after a sauna, he climbed back on the scale.
Charles Brewer, 11 stone.
And you can tell by the applause he made it with a little despair. Turned out he was the same exact weight as Calzaghe, 167 and three quarters. So fight on.
Too long once you get in that short, Gal, but that's where the success is coming from, short shots.
Keep
Come on, Gal.
Keep concentrating. Left hand first.
Now we enter round number four. Incidentally, Brewer insists he's not dehydrated or weak and is ready to fight. That should be a dandy. This is scheduled for 12 WBO Intercontinental Junior or Light Middleweight Championship. Gary Lockett, the hometown guy, is in the white trunks with the blue trim. Yuri Cerenko in the multicolored trunks, black, white, and red from Belarus. He's the Russian champ. And he's looked a little better than we anticipated. Cerenko. Lockett's letting him punch.
Beautiful left hook to the body there by Cerenko. He's measuring Lockett right now, and Lockett's not offering up much in the way of offense.
Yeah, Lockett just in a defensive pose, and he says, come on back. Sort of inviting him in, playing possum. But he's got to throw some punches himself. He says, all right, give me some more. Missing wildly is Lockett.
He's loading up with those shots, Steve. And you know what? Fighters can notice the tension in your shoulders when you load up. You pull back just a little bit. That extra second will make you miss that punch.
Lockett may be very eager, perhaps too eager, to put on an impressive showing here in front of his hometown fans. As mentioned, it's his home debut. He just needs to settle down a little and get into his game.
He needs to work in behind the jab again the way it was before. Beginning of last round and in the first round, working in behind the jab, stuffing it, getting his range, and then loading the combinations behind it.
He also wants to prove that he can handle people with a right hand as well. He says, don't make so much out of my left hook. He missed with those three shots, Lockett. And Cerenko smiles at him. And blood appears again on the right side of Lockett's face. I believe again from the nose. As Lockett brushes the blood aside from the nostril. Lockett, who broke his right shoulder when he was 12 and his left side became dramatically stronger, which may be part of the reason he has such a powerful left hook. But I think the crowd would like to see more of it. Cerenko, no. There's a left hook, but it wasn't a solid punch.
Cerenko's making Lockett miss a lot more than Lockett's used to missing, and you miss, you get tired.
And Lockett could be getting frustrated. As Cerenko looks at the body, it connects with a right uppercut to the jaw.
Sort it out. Box.
Cerenko has to be pleased thus far. As we come to the end of round four. Again, another wild miss by Gary Lockett at the bell.
Провали его, потом отбить. Ты много раз уклоняешься вправо от его левого прямого и удачно уклоняешься. Почему ты не добавляешь право прямой туда?
Gary Lockett here was back to the ropes. What happens is Cerenko just keeps the jab here, keeps tapping, tapping, tapping. Then he fires the right hand. He comes in with the left hook to the body, and he fires everything up inside. And there's nothing that Lockett can do about it. Just keeping it at bay, keeping his back up against the ropes, using that as a range finder. There's the uppercut, there's the left hook up top, right hand, left hook to the body. Working him nicely, clearly winning that combination. Now watch the big load-up shots by Lockett that miss. That one grazed, that one missed completely. The one before it missed completely. And here you see Cerenko smiling at him. He's not hitting with those big shots he's loading up.
Пятый раунд, Юр. Терпеть работать.
Cerenko's second fight in the UK. He fought in Sheffield. He met Southpaw Ryan Rhodes last year, losing a six-round decision, trying to even the score in the UK tonight, looking for the upset. He's fought mainly in Russia and the Ukraine from the industrial city of Vitebsk in Belarus. Round five scheduled for 12. WBO Intercontinental Junior Middleweight crown at stake. Owned by Gary Lockett right now. Coming off the impressive victory over Kevin Kelly. Kelly has been stopped in 38 their pro fights. The veteran.
There was nice counterpunches by both men, but Lockett landing the cleaner of the counters.
The veteran from Australia, and Lockett stopped him. But he's not looking that impressive here in his first defense.
Nose starting to bleed again by Gary Lockett.
That's got to be disconcerting. And a good left hand to the head by Lockett. Maybe his best punch of the night.
And he's hurt. Zarek with that a little bit. You can see a little bit of his leg, just a little wobbling.
Lockett's a very good finisher, but that time, Zarenko able to extricate himself from danger.
Well, one of the reasons why Lockett gets hit so flush by Zarenko is he doesn't move his head as much. And Zarenko, conversely, does move. He's had a lot more taking away from some of those blows.
Lockett trying to end this thing on one punch is, as you mentioned earlier, really loading up. And hard body shots by Zarenko. Right on the belt. And a good left jab by Zarenko. Lockett missing with a right cross.
Right! No shots, no shots. Come out.
John Coyle, who repped the Mike Tyson Lou Savarese fight. Glasgow, Scotland, third man.
You see the extra hesitation in some of Lockett's punches. He's loading up just trying to get that little extra oomph on the punch, and it's costing him to land. He doesn't land because Zarenko can see it.
Blood continues from the nose of Lockett.
Break! Okay, let go, guys.
Lockett trying a little tricky head out. Movement there, but he did not succeed.
Box.
As he continues to spit blood out onto the canvas. Good little left uppercut underneath by Zarenko. Lockett comes back firing, but missing with most of that. The blood worsens on the face of Lockett here in the fifth.
Every once in a while you get a cut, Steve, that just won't stop bleeding, even on the inside.
It looks like it's becoming very annoying.
Stop boxing! Stop
it
out.
Could be
okay.
A distraction for Lockett. We'll take you into Zarenko's corner. Our translator is Olga Lewis.
Thank you, sir.
Провалил. Накажи. Ниже он когда-то уйдет, понял? Дернул. Провалил он тебе ответил, я сразу ответил. Понял меня?
Да.
Отдергай его.
Drag him. Make him feel it. Don't let him get in the center.
Lockett working in behind the jab with the right hand, missing, but throwing big wild shots. The air grazing shot just can't get the range just yet. Big punches once again, loading up with him. He's missing, but making the effort.
As we hit round six, scheduled for 12. For the WBO Intercontinental Junior Middleweight Championship, 154 pounders. This is a division that houses Oscar De La Hoya, Fernando Vargas, Winky Wright, Daniel Santos. Those are the champions. De La Hoya set to finally meet Vargas in September. Wright meets Bronco McCart for a third time in July. He's already beaten him twice. Santos, the division's newest champion, could beat England's Wayne Alexander in his first title defense. So that's the division these guys are in, and someday Lockett would like to be up there challenging for one of those titles.
Right now he's got his work cut out for Zarenko right in front of him. Fighter whose record maybe doesn't indicate just how much he has.
Mentioned that earlier, Bobby. You heard me say that he's 12-6-1, but it may be misleading because of the fact that in the old Soviet Union, now Russia, they don't care who they put you in when they start you out.
You know, first fight, there's been times over the years that fighters walk right into 8 and 10 round fights, and sometimes that's not indicative of how they can fight with a little experience.
Lockett has been past four rounds only once in his career. A decision victory in London back in May of 2001. And he's never been past six rounds in his 16-fight career. 16-0, 13 knockouts.
He's pretty close to being past six rounds in a few short minutes.
Ocharenko with a beautiful right hand, and now a combination to the head.
Another follow-up combination too after that, because Lockett eventually countered him, but Ocharenko seemed not wasting the energy, being much more economical than Lockett, who has a reputation for being economical.
Don't tell me yet, but I'm curious to hear about your scorecard when we hit the halfway point.
Fair enough.
Keep me in suspense.
Break! No shots, no shots, both. Come out.
Less than 40 seconds, round six. The blood from the nose of Lockett continues. And Lockett's face looks really battered and bruised, doesn't it? The right eye is beginning to close a little bit.
He landed a nice right hand here, but missed the two follow-up shots. Once again, I think Ocharenko's just got the timing and the rhythm to slip Lockett's punches.
Ocharenko very active. And again, Lockett loading up with the right and the left and missing with both.
And it takes...
Break. Okay,
for every
no shots.
Action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. It takes energy to stop those punches.
He really telegraphed those shots. While Joe Calzaghe is regarded by many as the top super middleweight in the world, I'll tell you what, he doesn't impress Charles Brewer, the Hatchet, who shows no respect for the Welshman.
I find it very difficult to give this guy any compliments in terms of his level of opposition, his experience, his punching power, his skills. For every guy that he knocked out with five punches, I'll knock him out with two punches. It's hard for me really to compliment this guy. As a fighter, I don't believe that we're nowhere near on the same level.
Brewer feels Calzaghe is nowhere near the same level. That was some Hatchet job by the Hatchet.
Yes, it was, Steve.
You know I couldn't resist that.
But it was apropos.
Buddy.
Come on, Gal.
Lockett going past six for only the second time in his career. Round seven, Bobby Chez, your unofficial card.
You know what? I have it 3-3. I think Ocharenko's outworked him in a few rounds. He made him miss so many punches in some of those rounds that even though Lockett appeared to be the effective aggressor, he's working, he's not landing. Got to be effective. Key word, effective.
All right, we'll see what happens from this point on. The second half of the fight officially underway. Now let's see if Lockett has more success. He had a tough go at it here in his home debut in Wales. Born in Pontypool, Wales, makes his home in Cwmbran. C-W-M-B-R-A-N.
You know, the rap many times on big punches is that as the fight gets longer, they get less and less effective because they fatigue and tire and they need that power so badly. In this only six-round fight that Lockett's been in, it was a decision. Now we're past six. It'll be interesting to see how his power holds up in the later rounds.
And this is a guy, Bobby, who averages just 2.5 rounds a fight, Gary Lockett.
See, there's a big load up and a big miss. That's costly in the energy department.
Lately here on Showtime, we've seen many occasions where experience became a big factor. Could be the factor here tonight as well.
No, especially if it gets late because, Lockett has no experience going past six rounds, and at least Ocharenko has some.
No knockdowns thus far. Lockett's been down just once. He thought it was a faulty call, though. He more of an off-balance shot, but it was officially called a knockdown. And Ocharenko has been down only once in his career, but none of his six losses by knockout. He was down against Ryan Rhodes in Sheffield last time he was here in the United Kingdom. A fight he lost.
Ocharenko working that body again. For a right hand up top and left hand underneath. Lockett looking less and less effective.
Ocharenko, you remember you mentioned earlier he looks like he gets winded midway, but he looks winded, but he may have been playing possum.
I was just going to say, Steve, I think he was just playing possum because he just teed off.
Stop boxing!
He kind of doubled over as if he was out of gas, and then all of a sudden he just let fly with a couple of shots that connected. And I think he surprised Lockett. He is tricky. At 22
stop
years
boxing,
of
stop
age.
Stop boxing. Take care of the head, son. Box.
Fighter. Yuri Cirenko in the black, white, and red. And again, the busier of the two is Cirenko. A welt around the right eye of Lockett, the champion, a bloody nose. He sure looks like the loser to this point.
You know, sometimes Lockett actually works more, but lands less. So he may be busier, but not more effective.
Olga Lewis, our translator.
Good done. Well done.
No, 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 but no. It's going out.
No, no, no.
I'm the one. It's going out.
No, okay. Nothing. It's not coming out. Nothing.
It was coming out. Look at it.
Попробуй начать. Ты все хочешь правой с головы начать. Попробуй начать правой по пузу, а
try,
потом лево боковой в голову,
from,
ясно?
Try from the head. Try from the head. First try from the stomach and then go for the head.
В голову тебе. Ты под эту руку шагом бей и все. Достанешь. Попробуй. Да.
You watch here. As Cirenko's coming in this way, there's a little fire here, but then he loads up. He pulls back with his shoulder. He fires this left hook clear over his head. His right hand clear over his head. There's just one shot. There you just you see it. He pulled back his shoulder and loads it up, and it's not gonna land. Cirenko's too quick for that.
Well, we've gotten a report that Lockett's thrown 1.5 times as many punches as Cirenko, but he hasn't landed as many. Cirenko's landing more. He's given off Lockett a lot of effort, but he's not getting as much done.
There was a nice one, too.
Yeah, Lockett coming on here suddenly. Round 8, scheduled for 12 for a marginal title at 154.
Once again, missing quite a bit of the punches that he throws. Cirenko being more economical, and down the stretch, that's going to be key.
Well, he's getting back to the basics now, Lockett. He's jabbing and making Cirenko miss, but he didn't make him pay. Now the jab working, the shotgun jab just being stuffed in by Cirenko, but he didn't follow it up with a right. Here's the jab again, that time a right hand. This guy's awkward, Cirenko, and he's frustrating the champion.
Well, what he's doing is he's giving him a moving target, which is harder to hit.
Stop boxing!
And
stop boxing!
Quite okay, honestly, Lockett's loading up, which gives him that extra split second to get out of harm's way, and he does. See, when Lockett works in behind the jab, double jab, he's not only getting points, but he's lining this guy up. He's finding the range. He's got a range finder out there so he can measure with him.
He said he wanted to do more of that in our meeting with him yesterday, and he really has to continue to do just that. Nice right uppercut on the inside. That sent Lockett's head back. Left hook to the jaw by Cirenko.
See on the way, once again, Lockett's punching, but they're missing and he's getting caught. There he gets countered, blood spatters all over his face. Nice body shot by Cirenko, making Lockett miss and making him pay.
Cirenko's experience paying off. Caught 102 rounds coming in. Lockett only 41.
Now he established the jab there. Had Cirenko's head up. Yeah, had Cirenko's head up. Should have took it over the right hand, but he didn't.
Pardon me, Bobby. I just noticed Cirenko switched to southpaw just momentarily. Didn't get much done there with it. And now a shoulder movement by Lockett, giving Cirenko a little taste of his own medicine.
Nice stiff jab. He's got a follow up, and now Lockett switches his southpaw briefly.
Lockett with a welt under his right eye, a bloody nose, and Cirenko pretty clean face.
And this is not Lockett's fight, moving, going backward, but he was being fairly effective. Last portion of the round.
See him nicking the rounds there without taking. He got a nice body shot in then.
That was good boxing, son. That was good boxing. That was good boxing. Oh-ho.
It's all about this and not being in this game, gal, isn't it? Yeah. Hey.
Get on,
There's a nice exchange of combinations, firing at each other. There's a nice right hand, 1-2, right down the middle by Cerenko. And here comes Lockett right back, but he stops. When he has Cerenko moving back like that, he has to follow through. Step in with him and follow through.
Nice, nice stop.
You hear me? Yeah. Nice and sharp. Oh, sharp with your combos too. And stop reaching. If he's not there, the shot, they let him come onto them. Here we go. Hey, yeah. Off the jab and it all comes off it. Be smart, go.
Hands up, come be on, sharp again.
Lockett getting an earful as we enter round nine. This Welsh crowd has not really been into this fight simply because Lockett really hasn't given them much to cheer about.
In his corner, you heard him say, come and work off that jab. When the jab's working, you're working.
But Cerenko closing the range and smothering him.
See, this is generally not Lockett's fight. Power punchers don't fight as well going backwards generally. He's been boxing fairly well from the outside, but this is not his fight.
And one of those shots opened up the bleeding again from the nose of Lockett. There's the jab by Lockett.
Lockett's left eye is also getting really purple and ugly, swollen, starting to semi-close.
Lockett just keeps inviting Cerenko in, and I'm not sure that's a very wise idea. Cerenko says, okay, and then he goes to the body.
We're in the rounds now where fatigue will start to be a factor, 9, 10, 11, and 12.
And this is where perhaps Lockett has the upper hand, because as mentioned earlier, he's in fantastic condition. He does a lot of running. He told me he's never run a marathon, but he's come close. He runs 10 to 12 miles on the weekends, so he should be in great shape.
The flip side of that coin is he's never been this far, and the other fighter has. There he could be on the downside. Because right now he's not faring well, and I think experience has something to do with it.
Cerenko's gone 12 once. That's when he beat Andrei Pestroyev, who once challenged for a WBA world title.
Being a former fighter, I know when you hit those milestones, your first 10 and 12 rounder, it gives you a certain amount of natural innate confidence for the next time out.
Pestroyev also once went the distance with a fellow named Pernell Whitaker. Blood coming down the back of Cerenko, but it's from the face of Lockett. That blood is flying all over the place. Lockett continues to miss. Cerenko keeping Lockett at bay with the jab. And Lockett coming forward. And in a small ring, it favors the guy coming forward. Lockett with a body shot, getting a roar from the crowd. This is a very small ring, 18 feet.
Generally considered a puncher's ring when they're small like that.
Boy, that shiner getting worse and worse under the right eye of Lockett.
Lockett, see, there starting to work the jab nice, was being effective, but not working his combinations off that jab. Slipped some punches, but then didn't make Cerenko pay.
Joe Calzaghe up next with Charles Brewer. While Charles Brewer doesn't have many kind words for his opponent tonight, Joe Calzaghe offered this assessment of the Philadelphian.
Yeah, well, Charles Brewer's a good fighter. He's a dangerous fighter. I know I have to be at my best and be alert. He's a big, big puncher, and he has fast hands. The main key is I can take a great shot. That's the difference, you know, the chin. Is that I know when I land, he's going to be in deep trouble. I'm training very, very hard for this fight. It's probably going to be the toughest fight in my career. So, you know, as long as I perform at my best, I'm going to win. Simple as that.
The respectful Joe Calzaghe showing respect for his opponent in stark contrast to Brewer's analysis of Joe.
Now, come on, guys.
Round 10. You're three to go. That's it. Come in here now. Do it in here now. Gary, come on. Come on. Come on. This is the digging. Now, let's see how hard you are. Now, girls, come on.
The pep talk in the corner of Gary Lockett as they show a sense of urgency heading into round 10. It's getting louder and louder, and that welt under the right eye of Lockett is getting worse and worse.
You know that confidence I talked about when you reach the milestones of going 10 and going 12 in long, hard fights? Right now, Lockett's brain could be on overload. He'd be worried about those next two rounds, the next three rounds, and it could be affecting his performance. I'm sure he's in shape after all the work he's told us he's done, but mentally it's just as big a game sometimes as it is physically.
Lockett's title, albeit a fringe title, and undefeated record are on the line. 16-0 with 13 knockouts, and perhaps the pressure of trying to perform well in front of your hometown crowd also a factor. It's the first time Lockett's ever been in this position.
Southpaw again for Cherenko briefly. Ever so quickly and back to orthodox.
And Lockett on the retreat.
And the output gone down significantly for Lockett now.
And now Cherenko with Lockett on the ropes, which is not where Lockett wants to be, and he's pounding away to the body, Cherenko.
Some nice body work there by Cherenko, and I think that Lockett is, he's hit a little bit of a wall. I'm not sure if it's physical or mental or a combination of both, but he's hit a little bit of a wall. The output in his punches isn't there. The look in his eyes has changed.
Saw Francisco Panchito Bajardo, a rising young undefeated star, lose recently on Showtime to a relative unknown. Could we have a similar outcome here? Here's Lockett switching to southpaw. He's trying anything now. Now he goes back. Lockett continues to backpedal. He may have run out of gas.
It's certainly a possibility, never having been this deep in a fight. We don't know what's left in the tank. We heard about his running, the miles he puts in, the work in the gym. But if you miss all those big shots early, it will take its toll on you in the fatigue department.
Well, I'm not sure if Lockett has what David Tua has. We saw that last week. Tua was behind the entire fight. And then out of nowhere in the ninth, he can change it in a hurry, can't he? We saw it against Prezzo Kendo.
Right!
Tua
no
has
shots.
The vaunted left hook. Lockett has a very good left hook, certainly not in the category of the more experienced Tua. But we'll see if the left hook will save Lockett.
Юра, два раунда.
Юра, two rounds.
Понаглее с ним. Собраннее, но понаглее.
Don't fight him.
Понял меня?
You should be collected,
Юрка,
but beat him. Руки
beat не опускай. Подочнее, понял? Ломай его канатом.
Be exact.
Пробил, на волне отработай. Назад и опять пробей. Или пробил, уклонись, опять пробей.
Go
пробил
on
не опять
stop.
Пробей. Ты понял меня?
Do you understand
Волну
me? Yes.
Сделай. Два раунда осталось.
Two rounds
are left,
and then you will be champion. Just two rounds.
Но собраны руки, ясно? Ошибок не делай.
Your body shots, you'll stop and leaning on these ropes. Yeah. Do you hear me? You don't get caught with the body shot if you're using your legs. Do you hear me?
Gary, show your fucking heart. Let him know who Gary Lockett fucking is. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
Do you hear what I'm saying to you?
Six minutes to go.
Come on, come on, son. Come on.
Come on, Gary Lockett. Yeah. Come on, Gary Lockett.
You're on top now. You're right on top. Bing, bing.
Okay,
seconds,
thank go. You. Okay. Do you hear me? Let's be the governor now. Gary Lockett, the governor. Come on, Gary.
Colin Markbrock with the Newt Rockne speech.
A colorful version at that.
They are very, very worried in that corner. Well, that was obvious.
This fight is very close, and I actually have it dead even after 10. These two rounds, the championship rounds, what makes the difference?
And you heard through our interpreter Olga Lewis in the Cherenko corner that all they were saying was two more rounds, and you're the champion. Some dramatic stuff going on in both corners. We're in Cardiff, Wales. The supporting fight to Calzaghe Brewer. And a lot of people are surprised that this fight has gone this deep, particularly the Gary Lockett fans. Lockett making his hometown debut, coming in as the WBO Intercontinental Junior Middleweight Champ, 16-0, 13 knockouts, rated number 5 by the WBO, and having his problems with Cherenko.
And right now, Cherenko's teeing off on him, making him miss and putting the pressure on the corner.
There have been no knockdowns. Nobody has really been in trouble, but Cherenko has looked better than expected. And Lockett not as good as expected. The crowd trying to urge Lockett on. But he just doesn't seem to have that extra energy. Lockett back to the jab. Seems to have forgotten the much ballyhooed left hook.
Now he's just worried about putting any number of punches out there, hard, soft, lefts, rights. He just wants to score and win the round at any cost.
And you wonder what's going on in the mind of Cerenko. Just landed with a right, sort of a slapping right. Because, you know, it's so hard to take a championship away, especially in the other guy's hometown. Just don't know what's going on with the judges.
That's always a fact. The champions tend to get all the close rounds, especially in their hometown. The crowd sways the judges. It's very possible.
Blood streaking out of the nose of Lockett, who's getting belted around by Cerenko. All three judges are European, from France, Wales, and England. Cerenko continues to dictate, looking extremely confident. Lockett continues to go back. Not where he wants to be again. Cerenko with a right hand to the head, another right.
He's making Lockett miss on a regular basis and then land. That defense at Cerenko is what we call ring generalship. It's part of it.
Come boxing!
Well, it appears as if Cerenko may be in the lead.
Юра, твой центр.
Yours.
Дернул, ударил, дернул, ударил. Руки не опускать, понял меня? Руки не опускать, ясно? Ты понял меня?
Собрано,
дернул, ударил, канатом подвел, последний раунд.
This is the last round.
Что пойдет?
Water.
Нормально? Нормально?
Okay, yeah, okay.
Последний раунд. Канатом подвели.
Right, Gal, got to make sure you don't get a pop on this eye now. It's a bit of swelling on it, you hear me? Yeah.
Oh, you winning?
Well, yeah, you're winning. Let's make this round big,
you,
though.
You need this round.
Let's
you
win this round, and we're going to win it big. Sure. But don't take the risk, Gal.
Gary,
come on, Gary Lockett.
Hands up, Gary.
Take it to
Gary.
Him, Gary.
Hands up. Hands. Hold on a minute.
Let's go last round.
Come on. Take right, this last again. Round.
Hey, hey, hey.
Come on, Gary.
Hey,
up you get.
Hey,
go
hey.
Get him, Gary.
Here we go. Good. That's a wicked win. To win the fight.
I think if he wins the round, he gets a draw, and if he gets a knockdown, he wins it by two, wins the fight. I have it behind, 6 rounds to 5. Oh. And I'll tell you what, I noticed no inswell on that eye.
Yep.
He's just using Vaseline, no ice.
The cut man not doing much about that welt, Bobby, and it just opened up. It just splattered with blood. And perhaps the best thing for the fighter, as long as the blood is coming under the eye and not into it. Look at this, Cerenko. Oh.
Showing a good chin.
Cerenko looking to finish Lockett off with a 12. But you're right, Lockett not only showing good chin, but good heart.
There's no
right.
quitting Gary Lockett,
okay,
but he just
out,
doesn't
leg
have
out,
what
leg out.
Takes, I think, left in his gas tank to get this Russian out or down. And there's another right hand he walks into.
And that is a viciously ugly welt under his right eye. It is bleeding profusely. He's got blood coming from the welt and the nose. It's everywhere. Lockett's just looking for one punch here. He may have to do something dramatic.
Some blood finally coming out of the nose of Cerenko, too.
Cerenko looking winded. He's thrown a lot of punches. But Lockett's eaten more leather. Cerenko to the midsection again. Lockett's punches don't seem to have much behind them.
He's guarding his body and he's guarding the eye. He's worried about incoming
right.
more than
look
outgoing,
out.
And I don't know that he has enough energy to send that much out.
And he just checked the blood on his glove. It is not a pretty sight. This could be desperation time for Lockett. Under a minute left, round 12, because we just don't know what the judges have to say. I'm sure in Cerenko's mind, he
right.
feels
back,
that
pause.
He's got
back,
this
pause.
Thing. He just has to stay on his feet. Lockett.
The best combination. submission for Lockett in the past three rounds. Nice three punches, all landed solidly with power.
We hit the 30-second mark. Let's see how Lockett finishes.
Get away.
A bloodied Gary Lockett. As we approach 15 seconds.
Another left hook landed on that eye, and now a right hand to follow.
Both fighters exhausted.
Break! Let go, boys.
As we head for the bell in the final round.
Stop boxing!
What do you think?
Well, unofficially, I officially have it. For Shurenko. By two rounds, 7-5.
We'll see how the official ringside judges have it.
115-113 on my part.
Many of the fans on their feet applauding. But I'm sure they're wondering as well.
Their applause are subdued.
Very subdued.
Perfunctory at best.
I think some of the applause for Shurenko as well. So now we will stand by for the official decision.
Some highlights from that final round of action. Shurenko coming in on a regular basis, pressing the action late in the fight, landing a lot with the jab on the inside, but coming over the top with nice right hands and left hooks. There, the punches didn't land as cleanly, but not indicative of the round. The eye busted wide open under Gary Lockett's right eye, and Shurenko, there's a right hand. That's what was happening throughout the round. Leading in, looking tired, feigning, and taking Lockett. Look at that face. Lockett landed some good shots of his own toward the end, but far too little as far as I was concerned, and far too late. A gallant effort, but I don't think a winning one.
Gary Lockett threw more punches in the fight, but Yuri Shurenko landed more punches in the fight.
And only the ones that land count.
And it's now in the hands of Robin Dompierre from France, Roddy Evans from Wales, and Roy Francis from England. I don't think there'll be that much negativity should they call this fight in favor of Yuri Shurenko. I mean, these are pretty sophisticated fans, but I'm sure they're obviously pulling for this guy right here, Gary Lockett, who not only has a giant welt under one eye, a giant welt over the other eye, and his nose was bloodied for most of the fight. Of course, they're all pulling for Lockett, but it's so understandable if this guy, Shurenko, pulls it out. So we're standing by to throw it over to our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr., who has the results from the three judges. Over to Jimmy.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of action, we have a split decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Roddy Evans, scores the bout 115-113 in favor of Yuri Shurenko. Judge at ringside, Robin Dompierre, scores the bout 115-113 in favor of Gary Lockett. Judge at ringside, Roy Francis, scores the bout 116-115 in favor of the winner and new champion, Yuri Shurenko.
There you have it, Bobby, an upset. You had it right. And I thought it was a good call by the ringside judges.
I think it was a very good call. And, you know, some of those really close rounds, remember, when you switch one winner by 1 point, it becomes a two-point swing in the margin and in the decision. So I don't have a real big problem, but I thought Shurenko's clearly won the fight.
Bobby, as mentioned, these are knowledgeable fans, and they applauded the man from Belarus. No booing at all.
Not one bit of booing, and you know if they thought otherwise, they would have booed.
Absolutely. It is an accepted decision. A split decision for Yuri Shurenko, who takes over and wins this fringe title. So an interesting first fight here in Cardiff. Shurenko comes into the backyard of Gary Lockett and pulls off the surprise. There he is, the Belarus native, beats the Welshman and captures the WBO Intercontinental 154-pound belt. Shurenko needed to win the last round, we understand, to win the title, and he did just that by a score of 10-8, 1-1 scorecard. Interesting. So Cerenko improves to 13-6-1. Lockett suffers his first loss, falls to 16-1, and does so in front of his hometown fans. So an unlikely result, and remember, this was Cerenko's second fight in just 10 nights. Here are the official judges' scorecards. Dopierre had Lockett ahead by two, Evans had Cerenko ahead by two, and Roy Francis, the former referee, had Cerenko winning by one. So Cerenko wins by split decision. Coming up next, our main event. It'll be local favorite Joe Calzaghe putting his WBO super middleweight title up for grabs against former world champion and number six rated Charles the Hatchet Brewer. Into the dressing room of the unbeaten champ, Joe Calzaghe. It's been a slow, steady rise for the southpaw. Can he take his career to a new level? Captured the belt over a faded champion, Chris Eubank, about 5 years ago. And among his nine title defenses, wins over former champ Robin Reed, plus Omar Sheikha and Richie Woodall, his buddy. The rap on Calzaghe, particularly from Brewer, yes, he's beaten some champions, but at the end of their careers. Brewer says tonight, reality will set in. We'll soon see. Before we get to Calzaghe Brewer, let's see what's on the horizon right here on Showtime.
The torch has been passed and a new generation of fighters has emerged.
Get the shots off right away.
With the selfless dedication to the sport that their idols once had.
You had the dream, now let's make it happen.
Tough young scrappers eager to make their name and hungry to make their mark. Now watch them chase their dreams in the ring. When a pair of junior lightweight KO artists face off as the tough former champ Carlos Navarro takes on slugger Omar Adorno to see who's the last man standing on Showbox, The New Generation. Saturday, April 27th at 5 p.m. Eastern and Pacific, only on Showtime.
Showtime Championship Boxing presents the return of the Black Rhino. Clifford Etienne was an undefeated heavyweight phenom with stardom in his eyes until he was stopped in his tracks. Now, Etienne returns to prove that he can get to the top of the division. But his next opponent, the dangerous Terrence Lewis, wants to stop the Rhino from charging ahead. Etienne versus Lewis. It's two tough heavyweights headed for a showdown. Saturday, April 27th at 10 on Showtime, America's number one boxing network.